Malavika Menon, and I'm very happy to welcome all of you to the Lasya Mukharika series, Conversations on Mohiniyattam. This is a time of great uncertainty in several of our lives, and as human beings, I think this is an opportunity for us to reassess our lives and lifestyles and make way for some sustainable changes. As artists, this could also be a time for reinvention and introspection into our own arts and ourselves. Given this circumstance, I really wished to hear from and converse with artists in the field of Mohiniyattam who have been greatly inspirational. It is from this thought that the Lasya Mukharika series has been initiated, and I sincerely hope that this is beneficial to many Mohiniyattam students, performers, practitioners, and art lovers. I must sincerely express my gratitude to my guru, Srimati Vinita Nadungadi, for her constant support and encouragement as always. As you all know, today is our very first episode in this series, and I am really honored and blessed to have Padma Bhushan Dr. Kanak Rele ma'am as our very first guest speaker. Dr. Kanak Rele requires no introduction in the field of arts. She is an artist who has contributed invaluably to the art form of Mohiniyattam and has shaped her own distinct style in this field, which is very well acclaimed. I must also express my gratitude to Dr. Uma Rele ma'am and Dr. Sunanda Nair ma'am for their support and inputs in making this session happen. Dr. Kanak Rele ma'am too very wholeheartedly accepted my request, and although we couldn't get into a live session for this conversation, she very affectionately sent her answers through this video that I would like to share with all of you. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Namaste.
So the questions of Malavika Menon, I'll begin with the first one. How did you get introduced to Mohiniyattam? And what is it that drew you to the art form?
Namaskar. I would like to start from my training in Kathakali, Stri Veshams, a very, very difficult art of Kerala, from a very young age. And I was fortunate enough, I was really very fortunate to get a very great guru, Guru Karunakar Panikkar, who was very well known for his depiction of female roles, Stri Vesham. And he was called Panjali Karunakar Panikkar. I was under his tutelage, and I used to love performing. He doted on me and he taught me such nuances. But one must understand, I was away from Kerala, and there wasn't much scope for my presentations in Mumbai or Maharashtra. And I didn't know what to do. I just kept on practicing. And that is the time, that is the juncture, when a person who was in charge of the Keralaya Samajam here, he rang me up and said, Kanak Rele, there is a lady who has come from Kerala, and she knows what is Mohiniyattam. Now I must tell you one thing, I had heard of Mohiniyattam. I knew so many arts of Kerala. I had read up, I used to get introduced, I would go and see the performances of all these arts. This Mohiniyattam I had never seen, just read about it, and honestly I was very interested. I had heard some unsavory things about it, let's put it across like that. So I said, what do you want, why do you want me to do this? No, you see, you will like the art. I said, look, you know I'm Karunakar Panikkar's student and I'm practicing his style. No, I understand that. And then he blurted out, he said, look, this lady has come all the way from Kerala. Her name was Shrimati Rajalakshmi. She used to be formerly in Kerala Kala Mandalam, and now she has migrated to Mumbai, and she needs some work. Very naturally, she doesn't want any sort of charity doled out to her. She would like to work and earn her money. Why don't you learn some Mohiniyattam from her? I was very skeptical, honestly. I said, all right. But then when he said that, look, you must help out another lady. I said, all right, she's a woman. She's come to a very strange place all the way from Kerala. and this is Mumbai. Though of course Mumbai was not so terrible as it looks just now. It was a very lovely and placid place. And I said, all right, let's see, I'll learn something from her. So she came. She knew no English, she knew no Hindi, but she knew Malayalam. I understood Malayalam. Naturally, she was a Malayali. And she would do some hastas and we would somehow then go ahead. So I started learning from her. And I learned the first item. It's called Cholakatti. Once I learnt it, I don't know what metamorphosis took place in my body, my soul, my dancing soul. And I just, my God, such a beautiful style. But then I found they were all anomalies. It wasn't constructed around a tala structure. Wasn't constructed around any proper thought, thinking out of the sequences. But I said, let me learn. So I learned that. Then she taught me a padam, Swadhidurnal padam. I learned that. I learned these padams. After about 3.5 items, I said, I want to learn more. Bas itna khatam. I said, what do you mean, bas itna khatam? Teach me. Nahi aur nahi hai. Wo even in a broken way, wo mar gaya. Kerala mein mar gaya. Nahi hai. Are, how can I not die? That sort of prodded me, and I jumped up and I said, hey, look, this is not the way to talk. I took all my connections, I cajoled her, I pinched others and said, I would really like to know how it was danced in Kerala, what does Kerala feel about it? Now, in this turmoil and all that, I used to know the Ford Foundation people very well. And the chief there, he sort of, you know, he had advertised in the newspapers that if some performers, this was for dance, had some project where rare arts were to be learned or practiced or choreographed, he would welcome that. So if that is so, then I sort of, you know, somebody told me that, why don't you apply for it? I said, all right, let me see. So I applied for it and I said, I was very interested in Mohiniyattam. So I wrote something about it and I was called to Delhi for the interview. I went for the interview and he very straight away asked me, what do you intend to do? I said, sir, this art is almost dead. I want to go to Kerala. I'm having a performance tour of Kerala very shortly. I'm taking my musicians with me. I would like to go there. I would like to meet people who have seen this art, who have been involved in it. And I would like to, if I can, I want to record some. I'm told there are three old ladies. One lady was not very old, but two were very old. And I would like to record their dances for posterity, for me to learn. And he said, all right, you are getting the grant. Now, in those days, atmosphere was very different. I could not send money out of India abroad. I was going to Japan. He said, all right, the money will be waiting for you over there. I went there. I tell you, things were so easy. I was immediately given my money. I purchased the equipment and all that. To cut the long story short, I came back to India. And you know, I mean, I could not have brought that equipment through the customs. There, once again, one Maharashtrian gentleman whom I used to know and who always admired my art, he said, what have you brought this for? Sir, I'm being very frank. I want to record these ladies. All right, take it out. I didn't pay any duty, anything. I took out the equipment and I went to Kerala. And there I did not receive much encouragement or support. I didn't know where to shoot. And that is the way, where, you know, in the tourist bungalow in Cherudurthi, there was one, the man who was in charge was called Mr. John. So Mr. John was so angry. He said, oh, let them not cooperate with you. You will shoot here. You won't believe. The whole film has been shot in the dining hall of that tourist bungalow. And it was raining. Once it started raining, you would all gallop inside and go inside. Then once it cleared, I mean, Kerala is like that. We would go out and once again shoot. There were three old ladies, very old. Kunjukutti Amma, Chidamumma, and Kalyani Kutti Amma. Kalyani Kutti Amma was naturally Mrs. She was the wife of the great Kathakali artist. So that, you know, but other two, especially Kalyani Kutti Amma was so old and she was bent double like this. She could not stand straight. And poverty, stark poverty. My husband was, my husband Yatin, he's a very good photographer. He was going to take the film. He flatly refused and said, I'm so sorry. I am not going to exploit this old lady. She is ailing. There is something wrong with her. First of all, we will give her medical aid. Then only we will talk. I cannot do anything. I said, all right. So then I took her to a doctor and it was small little things, but she needed help. We gave her the medical support. And I tell you, that lady was, she was a firebrand. In her heyday, many, many, many years ago, she was the star performer. And even in those days, the spark in her eyes, unbelievable. And you know, when I went to meet her for the first time, bent double, she walked like this and looked at me like this, looked at my face, and then she declared to the world, she will dance Mohiniyattam. She is good. I didn't know. She died. She had not seen me. Anyway, Kalyani Kutti Amma, I shot. Then, of course, Chidambamma was very famous because she had the good fortune of teaching Vaijayanti Mala. And so Chidambamma was very, very pretty at that age. Fair, and what lovely skin. And she gave the Abhinaya part very soft. Well, that other lady was like a firebrand. And then Kalyani Kutti Amma, her husband was a very, very great Kathakali performer. She's very intelligent. And she had herself started working in choreography. Now, I had that small little camera, no sound in it. But I said, whatever it is, but I must shoot this. My husband Yatin, he shot the films. You won't believe, today that is the only extant proof of how Mohiniyattam was danced and say about, I don't know how many years, more than 100 years ago, 15 years ago, 25 years ago, whatever it is. But that is the proof. I didn't receive any support from there. I just went on and on and on. Much later, some time ago, some authorities wanted to possess those films. I said, no, I'm not going to give them. I have given them away to Nalanda. Nalanda owns those films. No, but you see, this is a very invaluable record. I said, it must be so. I'm not bothered. Nalanda is also a tremendous institution. And Nalanda has got a storehouse of recordings. I had the privilege of creating the storehouse. And these are the star performers. So this is the way. And then I would sit with those. You know, I made many copies of these films, edited them beautifully. And then I would screen them forward and backward to understand the body kinetics.
There's a question.
Yeah, I'll come to that. Body kinetics of what is Mohiniyattam. Somebody said, oh, it's a vishirishu art. Some people said, oh, it's very vulgar. Well, what is vulgar? I would say that vulgarity is in the eyes of the person who perceives. Art cannot be vulgar. And I fought for it and I think I have been successful. It's my life. And anywhere that I go, anywhere anybody talks of Mohiniyattam, now there's any number of dancers in Mohiniyattam. God bless them. But they all know who is Kanak Rele and what she did for Mohiniyattam. And this is my story, in short.
So the next question is, you have very closely worked with Sri Kavalam Narayana Pandithar over several years.
Yes.
What change came into your style of Mohiniyattam after you were introduced to the art of Sopanam? Please share your experiences with Sri Kavalam in creating several iconic choreographies over the years.
Don't call it art of Sopanam. Sopana Sangeetam. Now, you know what happened? This was also providential. I have Nalanda and I would go to Nalanda daily to work and all that. And one day a Malayali friend, a very high ranking officer, he rang me up and said, Kanak, you know, there is one gentleman who has come from Kerala. And then he says, you know, he does this mad sort of nataks. I said, what mad sort of nataks? What the hell are you talking about? Now he does some experiments and all that. Anyway, he has told me, we belong to the same village in Kerala. He said, I want to meet this Kanak Rele. So I said that, all right, I know her very well. He knew Yatin, my husband, also very well. He would come to her house. So can I send him to your house? I said, yes, why not? I was ready, and you won't believe, a big battalion came to my house. Mr. Panikkar, Mrs. Panikkar, Mr. Panikkar's two sons, one of them had their wife, their assistants, their singers and everything. I'm just stunned and looking at the whole lot. And I was very happy, and Panikkar said, oh, you know, I've heard so much about you. I want to see your work, you know. Can you show me a little bit? Well, I had my musicians with me and I performed. I performed something. I said, look, this is it. And he started talking. He told me, he said that, have you realized one thing? You are a Kathakali artist, I know. I know his wife had seen me on the stage. So I know you know what is Sopana Sangeetam. What is Sopana method of singing? You know that? Yes, I know that because I was brought up in it. And he said that, look, that Sopana very properly handled would be beautiful for Mohiniyattam. Well, the floodgates opened, and on the spot, within 15 or 20 minutes of our meeting, both of us decided we wanted to work together. And there arises this iconic collaboration. My giving the dance and the Natya Shastri tradition, how to move the body, and my theory of body kinetics was already formulated, and I had published it. I had received some very wonderful reports about it. The Sangeet Natak Academy had helped me in that. And I was working seriously in trying to see how my theory of body kinetics fitted into the Mohiniyattam thing, and I was successful. But there was this gap. My dance was my physicality, my body. My body knew how to move and how to sweep. I needed music. I needed music to fit it. Now please remember one thing. I know Kerala system of music. I know Kerala system of taras, because from the age of 6, 7 or 8, I was brought up in that, and I had a great guru to teach me. And in that I had gone ahead and gone ahead. So when Kavalam said that we use our Kerala Tala cycles, Tala systems, well, nothing was new to me. I said, yes, let's do that. But then that man had done so much of research, and he started giving me the Vaitaris. Now Vaitaris are, you know, what you call them, bowls. Bowls you have.
Sholus.
And you have one sequence of four avartanas or something. And in that it is there. But what lilt was there? He said that then I was fortunate. I had beautiful Kerala musicians. For vocals, I had M.S. Kirishan. For physical work and all that, Gopalakrishnan was there. My drummers were there in those days. Four of them were there. And I invited Kavalam. I said, would you come to Mumbai? I went to Kerala. And he said, you are pretty young and you are very, very beautiful to look at. You are not going to stay by yourself. And his wife, they know you cannot stay, you have to stay in our house. Well, whatever it was a crowded house. His sons and nephews and nieces, the whole lot coming there. I became one with the family. And I would sit with them, I would go to the kitchen, help out. And you know, Kavalam would love talking. He would be eating with some morsels in his mouth. And you know, this weather, you know, this tala will be very good. I would say, please finish your food, then we'll talk about the tala. I was that close to him. And he would laugh and we would work. How much we have talked about what is Kerala arts, what is Kerala ethos. And he said that, look, you are more Malayali than most Malayalis are. But that's a compliment I receive everywhere. Everywhere I receive this compliment. And yes, I love Kerala. I love Kerala arts. I was brought up in it by my guru, Karunakar Panikkar. And that is where my psyche is. That's where my creativity is, and that's how I love performing. So here Kavalam and I clicked. But then we decided, I said, Kavalam, I'm tired of it. Oh my Lord, why are you not looking at me? I'm becoming thin. I said, I don't like this. So he said, what do you like? I said, I'll tell you what I like. You will have to write for me. He would do that. I will write, but I must like what you are saying. I said, all right, I want Draupadi. What? So Draupadi. So I told him, I said that this is what it is. Draupadi. Oh, she suffered. No. She suffered, but she was a rebel and she spat at the world. I want to do that. I will not write anything like that. You will have to write. Then Mrs. Panikkar storms into the room and said, why will you not write? What Kanak says is correct. That is what it is. We have to present women's problems. Hey, you are going to write. She became my ally. And we created such marvelous, you have seen, people have seen what that repertoire is. I feel some people have tried to do something, emulate what we have done. But that tuning that I had with Kavalam, then Kavalam said, okay, you know, when you take one coin, the coin has two sides. One side is Kavalam, one side is Kanak. We are both KKs. He said like that. Well, that is how I built it up. And in my things, and please don't misunderstand. Kavalam wrote, set the music, and then the Tala experts would come. But we also worked for the Ashtapadis. Kavalam loved Ashtapadis. We will work on Ashtapadis. We have created Ashtapadis, but once again casting them in the Sopana Sangeetam mode. So that is how today, at my disposal, I have about 65 new items. And I can never forget my dear friend Kavalam. And when he passed away, I must tell this much, that I received a call from his family and said that he's not well. Well, it was a Saturday. So I told my team, I mean Gopal Krishna and Girishan, that Kavalam sir is very ill. He was in the hospital. So we decided that we would dash to Kerala, Trivandrum. And on a Sunday, we took the morning flight and we reached there. His son Sri Kumar, who used to earlier sing for me, a fabulous singer, he was waiting for us. And we went to his house and he was lying down. And I went near him and I sat down. And he could not speak. It doesn't matter. Rest. That you and I together. I said, yes, of course we are going to work. You get up soon from there, okay? No, you are going to get up. Get up. I will. And then he said, so we wanted to work on the talas of Mohiniyattam. So both of us will work. Yes, of course we will work. I was sitting there with him. And suddenly, you know, we were dear, dear friends in the art world. And suddenly, he put his hand out like this. And he did this. I gave him my hand. And two very, very fast friends. We were friends at the artistic level. Please understand. We just sat there for 10-15 minutes just holding each other's hands. He kept on smiling at me. I was smiling at him. And I thought that his life was ebbing away. And then he sort of shut his eyes. I had to immediately go to the airport to return to Mumbai. It was a Sunday. Monday was a working day for us. So all the three of us rushed to the airport. We land in Mumbai and there is a call and my heart stopped. He informed me he passed away. I was the last person with whom he related and with whom, he saw, you know, you and I, we are together. Yes, Mr. Panikkar, we are together. I never called him Kavala. So, this is what it is. This is my collaboration with a very great person.
Wonderful.
So, the next question is, you have contributed a great amount of valuable research towards Mohiniyattam, right from its stylization to bringing about some scientific theories. Would you please give us some insight on the fundamental aspects of your theory of body kinetics?
Yes, body kinetics, you know, the body kinetics, what I did was, it intrigued me. How does the body move in the space around it? Now, this goes much beyond Mohiniyattam or anything. It is my theory. And I used to work, I must say, I used to work with physically challenged children. And I used to use dance movements for therapeutics for them. And I tell you, I had lovely success. I mean, you were a part of my team, weren't you?
Yes.
So, you know, we got success. You know, you used to come with me and we
yes.
got tremendous success.
Yes.
And what did we do? What did I do? I used to tell you people that this child, you remember that Muslim boy?
Yes.
Hanif. He was like this. Hanif. He was like this. And everything was, you know, in a bad shape. And when I said, ke, Hanif, chalo, haath yun karo, nahi karega, kya karegi? I said, chup, don't talk such rubbish. ऐसे बात नहीं करना है करो तुम आई वर्क विद हिम आई वर्क विद हिम एंड टू अ ग्रेट हैप्पीनेस आई मीन आई गेव हिम दीज मोमेंट्स डांस मोमेंट्स एंड देन आई रियलाइज कि वुड रिलेट समथिंग सो आई सेड कि पंछी कैसे उड़ता है तुमको पता है इफ यू रिमेंबर एंड आई सेड देखो पंछी नहीं उड़ता है एंड ही वॉज लाइक दिस एंड स्लोली हिज हैंड्स मूव्ड आउट आई मीन आई हैड ट्रेमेंडस सक्सेस देयर I know that there was one part of me who wanted to work on this. Now this is where my theory of body kinetics come. And the kinetics is how the body moves in the space around it. Kinesphere as I call it. And this kinesphere, I have to move and it, each style, each classical Indian dance style has its own specific kinetics. That is the actual way in which the body moves and what is the angle, what are the angles that is there. So then you know if you go to Bharatanatyam, it is it's angular, but you go to Mohiniyattam, then this and this and this and this. So this is volution and revolution. When that was V's, everything goes in V's, that is volution, and this is revolutions. Now you know there was one very great scholar. He was a chief man for all our all historic things and all that. I don't remember his name just now. And I used to go to him all the way to Chennai to study from him. What is kinetics? What do I do? And he would tell me so many things. So you know he said that you tell me what you feel. So I said, sir, I feel that. There are two streams in Indian classical dance. The way the body moves in the kinesphere, the space around it, I say. And I said that one is this rounded movement and the other is the angular movement. Now there can be some give and take, but these two solid compartments are there. So he said, what do you call them? I babble, something or the other, I don't know what I say. So I am not very sure what I want to call them. So he said that, When you go round, why don't you call it revolution? I said, yes, sir. So that is a wonderful thing. And when you go in V's, where you say your Bharatanatyam belongs, you call it volution. Now these are the two terms that revolution was okay, but volution he coined. He said that volution and revolution. Now this is the theory which I apply to all my classical dance styles. It has become a part of the University course at Nalanda Nritya Kala Mahavidyalaya. You people teach it.
Yes.
But it simplifies the learning where you know now the challenge is one dancer learns at least 4 or 5 styles. Jumps around here, jumps around there, everything. Maybe it is need based. I don't know why it is being done. I never did it. But okay, if that is the way they want to live, that is their lookout. I have no objection. But at least they should keep the compartments clear. Now it's very difficult that if you are a Bharatanatyam dancer, you would be doing volutions. And if you are doing, you are a Mohiniyattam performer, you would be doing revolutions. How do you keep a balance between these two? Well, that's a big challenge and that depends on the dancer.
Wonderful.
Next question and the last one.
Yes.
Having lived a life dedicated to Mohiniyattam in performance, teaching and research, what do you feel about the art form now? Is there any scope for expansion and exploration?
I have expanded it from 3.5 items, all broken items where Tala system was thrown out of the window. I have created more than 60 items. It's a rich repertoire which is being taught at Nalanda Nritya Kala Mahavidyalaya. Some of the students come and learn privately from me. Now here the art is expanding. One would like it to expand more. But I would like to sound a caution. And that is that unless you understand what is the kinetics of dance style, this kinetics seeps into the music also. So if you go to this Bharatanatyam, when they recite the syllables, I mean, I know show loose, but syllables, cut, 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 I dance to this, I dance to this, you know, sometimes I do this. Because this is the way Mohiniyattam goes. The Mohiniyattam will be all rounds, and by the time I go, it comes back. Now this is the way the body moves. If you started with this in Mohiniyattam, well, it's not Mohiniyattam. Then God knows what attam it is. One doesn't know what that is. So this is the thing I do very seriously feel. Nalanda students know this item, both the theories very well. You yourself are teaching it.
Yes.
So Nalanda students know, the performers know, my students. Now for instance, Deepak Mazumdar, he is a Bharatanatyam dancer. But he does, I have told him, I have specified for the Bharatanatyam body kinetics. I have taught him in that. Sunanda Nair, a fantastic Mohiniyattam performer. Well, she follows my style. So this is the way it goes. And I feel that if the teachers, today's teachers, instead of sitting there with a doing that and all that, otherwise, do like this, aisa karo tum aisa karo, aisa karo. Instead of that, if you use some sketches, if you told them that, arey Baba, in this Bharatanatyam, this is angularity. You have seen that, you know the
yes.
sketches. So this angularity is there. In Mohiniyattam, angularity is not there at all. It is just a beautiful round and round flow. If you are able to convey these to the students, at least their performance comes to a certain level. Now this is where I had a discussion, and I say that the kinetics part, the theoretical part, every part, your tradition, what you are born in, we were all born in this tradition. That is 80%, 80% of a dance. Well, that's a very good standard, because 80% if you are performing, then you are neat, you are cut, your eyes, your eyebrows, everything, your breath. I mean, you know, I work on Shwasa. All this is very beautifully synchronized. You are a fine dancer. Beyond this, other 20% is what you are, where your soul belongs. How you love the art, how do you embrace it? I embrace my Mohiniyattam. I literally embrace, and I think that, oh, it's beautiful. Now I'm old, and after this recent mishap on my foot, I don't dance so much, but I sit and do all the beautiful movements. And the movements are like in Kathakali, in Kerala system, you are made to sit on the ground, asana, and then you are expected, you have to perform the abhinaya, mukhaja abhinaya, hastabhinaya. Up to this, you sit and master that abhinaya in Kathakali technique. That's how I was taught. Then you get up. Hey Guruji, utke karogi? Nahin, nahin, idhar udhar bhagega, baith jao. Baith ke karne ka, aisa nahin karne ka. This is what he said, and I believe in it. Because Kathakali is, by the way, in Mohiniyattam it's not that. Bharatanatyam is totally different. Everything is different. But your physical stance and everything, if they are clear cut, from there you pick up. Your 20% is left on one side. That is for you. And I think it is not you, but your love and your dedication to your art and your surrender to the God. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.